YouTube.
Not a lot of history right here. I do promise the real history is of our last little stairway to heaven. Everything behind me is going to be that original building from 1898. But we're a lovely large group here. We've got some small spaces up in our brothel. So I'm going to give you a little bit of this oral history right down here before we head on upstairs. So the Red Onion was built in 1897. And then opened as a saloon and brothel in 1898. So back then, Skagway was a town of 15,000 men and 300 working women.
Woo!
Yeah, I'm exhausted just thinking about that math. But if you had been one of the gentlemen, you would have walked in downstairs, bellied up to the very same bar we have today. You would have ordered yourself a shot of liquid courage, and then noticed a row of 10 little rag dolls behind the bartender. These dolls were made to look like the 10 live dolls living and working upstairs by their hair color, eye color, even the color of the dress you may or may not have been wearing by the time you got to work. But you would pick a doll based on your preferences. You would tell the bartender and he would take the doll and lay her on her back. That would indicate that she was going to be busy, but only for the next 15 minutes.
That long?
Yeah, the gentleman was a little nervous. Don't worry, we can always find something to do with those other 12 minutes. Very good listeners here at the Red Onion, of course. But he would then make his way up a ladder-like staircase. The bouncer would greet him at the top. Bouncer leads him down the hallway to the lady of his choice, and then the first rule of prostitution would come into play. Does anyone know what that is?
Money.
Washing.
I don't know why it would be washing. Payment, of course. You gotta pay before you play. So you would give her $5 in gold coins. She would take the money, put it in a safe spot while you spent the next 15 minutes together. And when you were all finished, she would take the money, place it in a hole in the floor. This hole was connected to copper pipes that ran all the way back downstairs behind the bar to a safety deposit box. So the bartender would hear the gold clanking against the copper pipes. You would see a satisfied customer coming downstairs and know which doll he needed to prop right back up to attention, indicating she's once again open for business. We do still have one of those money holes intact here. You will walk past it on your way into the museum. It will be on your left on the floor. But as tempting as it might be, please don't go sticking any money in there. If you have somewhere you want to put your useless cash, I can help you out with that after our tour. But I don't want you to put your money in there now because it's no longer connected to those pipes. When this building was purchased by its current owner, Madam Jan Redmore, in 1978, she wanted to put the kitchen in downstairs. Those old copper pipes were a grease fire hazard, so they had to be removed. But in order to do this, they had to lift up the original floorboards, and that is when they found valuables girls had stashed under there for safekeeping 80 years prior, and now over 120 years ago. Those artifacts are on display throughout our museum, and I think we're just about ready to head on up and take a look. But I do have a couple of ground rules before we get going. I see we do have beverages in hand, and that is fabulous. The more you drink, the funnier I get. But I do just ask, whatever glass goes up, comes back down when we're all finished. We don't want to leave it in there. And we are a look, don't touch establishment, all right? So please no touching any artifacts or wallpaper or tour guides. Our services have changed since 1898. But once we're upstairs, take all the photos and videos you want. I just ask that you turn your flash photography off. There are light-sensitive artifacts in our museum. But that being said, I do have an artifact in this very room. You're more than welcome to flash all you want. And that would be the Red Lantern right here, of course. Now, this is one of two original Red Lanterns. It hung outside of the Red Onion all the way back in 1898. This would have served a shining beacon of hope for those dirty, stinky, thirsty gold miners. It would let them know that we served a little bit more than liquor upstairs. And as you all can see, for over 120 years, she's still turned on. And isn't that very lucky for all of you folks? So what do you say? Should we head on upstairs and finish the tour that is? Do make sure you have all of your personal belongings. We'll return back to this room. And if you're ready, you can follow me right this way, folks. Bye-bye, man.
These women. They're actual women. That was taken by the local judge. Very cool.
Building, like I mentioned. And as I said, we lifted up these floorboards to find amazing artifacts that have been stashed under here. And those artifacts are on display throughout our museum. And when you do take a look, you're going to notice that not everything's from the Gold Rush. And that is because this building was only a brothel for 2 years during the Klondike Gold Rush. We've done many different things since then. We've been a radio station, telegraph station, television station, pharmacy, laundromat, gift shop, post office, wow, and even World War II Army barracks.
Wow.
So really servicing men any way we can since 1898. But my favorite artifact we found is going to be the electric curling iron to the left of this far case here. This is an electric curling iron from 1898. So Skagway had electricity back then, but it doesn't plug into the wall like we're used to today.
But they had a curling iron, that's amazing.
Mm-hmm, that's right. So the electricity ran through the ceiling by knob and tube wiring. So if she wanted to curl her hair with that iron, she would have to hop up on her bed, unscrew the light bulb, screw in the end of the curling iron, wait for it to heat up, curl her hair in basically the dark, unscrew the curling iron, screw the light bulb back in, and hop on down.
That was in my basement.
And I would say we're very lucky we don't have to do that much screwing to curl our hair nowadays, folks. But I will say that the largest artifact we have is surrounding us here. It's going to be the wallpaper. So the wallpaper you see here and in all of our rooms is original to the building. Almost all of it dates back to the Gold Rush. Wallpaper actually played a very important part in our history here. We have the reputation of being, well, the classiest brothel in town because of it. What would actually happen is during this time, the madam, she would go out in the streets, find the best looking girl she could, the one she thought would make her some money, and she would say, why don't you come work for me? I'll take care of you, clothe you, feed you, you will have your own room. You can even decorate it and pick out your wallpaper. So it actually means that the wallpapers you see in our next room represent a lady that worked here at the Red Onion. Speaking of our next room, we are a one-way street here at the brothel, so I'm gonna let you look around here, take those photos and videos. Of course, I will be in our next room to continue the tour. Just remember, you really only paid for a quickie, folks. So don't leave the lady waiting too long in there. And as a little reminder, that money hole is located in the back there and the curling iron to the left of this case right here.
It's on the hole.
It's up on the ceiling when that new room ceiling fell in. That's exactly what we're doing.
Going down with my dining room ceiling.
You get a free go after it.
Layers of wallpaper in one room. We're only a brothel for 2 years, so it indicates a very high turnover rate. You know why it would be so high? Disease, pregnancy, violence, and the most common thing was everyone who came here to Skagway was in a hurry to get out of Skagway. We were to stop on the way to the gold fields. That was a very difficult journey to make. Many women found themselves stuck here. They needed to survive and ended up joining the trade, but this was not a glamorous life, and Skagway was a very rough and violent town, so these rooms upstairs could become vacant overnight. But many experts do believe the violent past has led you now onto the present. We still have one girl that walks our halls. Her name is Lydia. She's our resident ghost. Lydia lived, worked, and unfortunately died just about where I'm standing here. This would have been her room. But I promise, she's a harmless spirit. Lydia is more playful. We'll sometimes just find things moved around, feel a pull on our skirts, a caress on our arm. But she is more fond of the ladies, I have to say. So gentlemen, watch your step on the way out of here, okay? We have had a cook and a maintenance man claim to be shoved down the stairs by an unseen hand, and they blamed Lydia. I do believe it was a different ghost to blame for that incident, though. But we have received photos and videos from our guests of their tour guide here. We've seen floating orbs, blurs, and even faces that appear in guest photographs and videos. We've seen this before. It's quite incredible, so do let me know if you think you see Lydia on one of your cameras. But this area is another one of our favorites because of the dress right here in this case. It's one of our most prized artifacts. It's made of silver-plated copper pieces that have been wrapped around a cotton or linen neck and then crushed into place. The back of the dress is cotton muslin, and it weighs about 12 pounds, so that's why we lay it out flat like this. And it would have been worn under a lady's garments as a form of lingerie. Yeah, and it definitely belonged to a madam. Only madams could have afforded this much finery at the time, but we know it didn't belong to our most famous madam, though. Her name was Diamond Lil Davenport. She was quite an unusual madam because most just took care of girls and money, but she would take care of men too, for a price. Diamond Lil charged $100 an hour, or $1,000 for the night. That is roughly $35,000 today. She was described as a ravishing beauty, an alabaster goddess, a very curvaceous woman who stood at 6 feet tall. And in addition to her prices, every man had to have three documents. He needed a clean bill of health, a letter of recommendation, and of course his most recent bank statement. I know, I've tried it before. It really does wonders for your love life. She was a smart woman, I have to say. But when Diamond Lil walked these halls, well, the Red Onion wasn't at this location. Originally, the building stood on 6th and State, and they moved it here in 1914 to be closer to the railroad. But they moved the building using just one horse, four rolling logs, and of course a bunch of early Alaskan men. So they surrounded the building, pushed it down Broadway, got it here, set it down. As you can imagine, they were very tired after that, so they decided to go in for a drink. But that's when they realized that they were walking in the back door facing the front side of the street. They put the building down backwards. But we have a saying here, you can do things the right way, you can do things the wrong way, or you can the Skagway. These gentlemen chose the Skagway. They decided to cut the front off of the front, the back off of the back, switch the two sides around, nail it back together. That is still the Red Onion we have to this very day. You will notice that cut line in our next room, but I'm going to go ahead and describe these next two rooms since they are much smaller. This right here is our only intact crib room. If you look up at the ceiling, you're going to see rows of nails. That would have been where the walls once stood up here. So we're currently in about 2 1/4 crib rooms. We had 10 crib rooms upstairs, each for a lady. So 10 of these in the corner, you will see a 3/4 twin bed. That is the size of the bed the girls slept and worked out of. You're going to see pinups from our World War II Army days. Next to those in a frame, you'll see a silk stocking. One of many we found shoved in between the walls would have been insulation or soundproof. Below the window ahead of you, where the wood looks a little bit different, is going to be the cut line I told you about. And next to the window in a frame is going to be a small bottle of Lysol. So Lysol was actually used at this time as a feminine cleanser to prevent against STDs and pregnancy. And the formula in 1898 much stronger than it even is today. This is one of the original intended uses of the product. So as you can already imagine, that is very dangerous and uncomfortable. So these working women were very strong and brave here in Skagway during the Gold Rush. When you cross the hall over, you're going to be in the madam's room. The first thing you'll notice is it's much more luxurious than the little front room. That is because madam's took 50% of the $5 that the girls charged. The bouncer got 25%, so they were left with $1.25 per customer. Which is not a lot of money, but you have to keep in mind the respectable occupations in town only paid a woman $3 for a whole day of work. The cost of living in Skagway was $6 a day, so women just weren't left with many options for surviving here. So these ladies would work at the brothel. Everything taken care of for them. They would work from 6 p.m. to 6 a.m. 15 minutes with a customer, they could do pretty well for themselves. And most of these ladies not only survived, they really built Skagway to what it is today. These women were some of the most consistent residents, some of the wealthiest residents. They were constantly here, dedicating their time, money, and energy into Skagway. These ladies would go on to become some of the first land-owning women here in Skagway. So we really do walk on these foundations that they have built here. And lastly, folks, when you're finishing on up in the madam's room, that would have been where Diamond Lil stayed when she was here. But she did not get her name for nothing. They say when she left the north, she was wearing enough diamonds to light up an entire hotel ballroom. Diamond rings on every single finger, 2 4-carat diamond garters on her thighs, and even a diamond on her tooth. She was a terrific businesswoman. She was honest. She was never arrested, and she only employed the best of the best here. But Diamond Lil made the first mistake of prostitution. It's happened to you two, I'm so sorry. She's right, though. She's right. Diamond Lil fell in love with a client, Big Joe Hopkins, moved on down to Seattle together.
Big Joe.
But she didn't check his references well enough. He was a con man and a gambler, and he took her for every diamond she was worth. She ended up as a scrub woman, scrubbing the floors at a Seattle bank at the end of her life. But one day, a reporter walked in. He recognized her as Diamond Lebeau. He said, "Diamond, I have to know what happened to you." She looked up at him and she said, "Honey, I may be on my hands and knees, but at least this time it's in a respectable occupation." So at least Diamond Lebeau kept her sense of humor to the end. It is what I love best about her. She lived to be about 90 years old. I will have a picture of Diamond Lebeau you can sneak a peek at on your way out. But folks, speaking of endings, I'm so sorry to say it's the end of all I have to say for our quick meet upstairs. I'm going to let you go through the museum yourselves, but I'll be waiting for you at the exit. If you have any questions, if you need any photographs, of course, or if you have enjoyed your time and you want to make a deposit into the First Bank of Alaska, you can feel free.
Just don't feel me, alrighty?
But one favor to ask, and as you're headed back downstairs, if you don't mind, just looking a little worn out for me. Put some smiles on your faces. You can even hooper holler. I just have reputations to uphold. I think I'm doing upstairs here, folks.
How did Lydia die?
She unfortunately took her own life upstairs here.
Way to bring it down.
I know. Oh, I
folks, if you do have any other questions, I'm so happy to answer those, but I'm going to be waiting for you at the end, all right?
together.
Problem?
Hey, you want to see something really cool?
Very cool. I wonder why they paint the wall, the white walls, tires, stone. White tires, white wall wheels. For a press record. So at the minute there's three cruise liners in, and I think that striper blue and white one was in Valdez when I was there last week, so that's all possibility. But this is Skagway. Might look into that might pass tomorrow actually. Yeah, I can see when the cruise ships pack it in and everybody's back on board by a certain time. This place is going to be quiet. Everybody shuts up then.
Rich.
I'm not looking at her ass, honest. Well, might be. In fact, yeah, it's possible. Yeah, you know how damn well I am.
There it is.
This is definitely a cool place. Really cool place. I don't know how much you're gonna see of that. Very cool. Incline.
Turn left onto Dying Flats Access Road.